In this video, we're going to discuss the role of active power control in electric power systems. We will also look at the importance of having inertia in the system. We're going to see what does having an active power balance mean, and why is frequency an indicator of the active power balance of the system. We will see what is the role of inertia in the network and the effect of having generation units connected to the network via power electronics interfaces. An active power balance exists when the power generation is equal to the power consumption in the network. The figure shows the hierarchical active power control scheme in conventional power systems, where we find primary, secondary, and tertiary control. In a nutshell, primary control is in charge of keeping the active power balance. Secondary control is in charge of restoring the frequency and the power exchange between different areas of the network. Finally, tertiary control is used to restore a sufficient secondary control volume. We will cover each of these control mechanisms in more detail in the coming videos. But before we do so, let's briefly review the basics of power control. Frequency is a global variable in the system. In general, any power variation in the load or generation will lead to a frequency deviation. For this reason, frequency is an indicator of the power balance between generation and consumption in power systems. If the power generation exceeds the total demand, the frequency increases. An example is when a large load is disconnected from the system. If the power generation is lower than the total demand, the frequency drops. This occurs, for example, when the outage of generation units takes place. In a traditional turbine-based generation unit, the rotor speed remains at its rated value as long as there is balance between the mechanical power, which is the input, and the electrical power, which is the output. If there is a disturbance at the electrical network side, then the electrical power changes. Consequently, a mismatch between the mechanical and electrical power is created, resulting in the appearance of an accelerating power. When there is a mismatch between the mechanical and electrical power, the rotor speed or frequency changes according to the total inertia constant of the rotor shaft. The formula shows the relationship between the accelerating power and changes in frequency, here represented by its time derivative. The inertia constant is represented by the term H and is divided here by the base network frequency. The inertia constant depends on the angular momentum J of the turbine generator set, on the system-based power SB, and on the angular speed of the rotor omega squared. Note that the angular momentum J depends on both the mass and the geometry of the rotor. Any generator with a rotating mass that is directly connected to the grid provides the inertial response inherently. This effect cannot be obtained if the generator is connected via power electronics interface. Steam turbines of traditional thermal power plants are an example of generators that are able to provide inertia to the system. Steam turbines have an inertia varying between 6 and 8 seconds. Inherent inertial response is also provided by gas turbines and pumped hydro units, which provide inertia in a range between 2 and 3 seconds, up to 5 or 6 seconds. Among the renewable energy sources, fixed speed wind turbine generators are also able to provide a low level of inertia, typically between 2 and 4 seconds. This is possible because fixed speed wind turbines are directly coupled with the system and their speed depends on the system frequency. Most of the renewable energy sources implemented in microgrids are electronically interfaced to the power network. This means that generation units like variable speed wind turbines, PV, fuel cells, batteries, and electric vehicles are not able to provide the inertial response, because there is no direct coupling of a rotating mass. This is why microgrids, including high penetration of distributed generation units, face a lack of inertia. To overcome this challenge, an auxiliary control loop, the so-called inertia emulation loop, can be added to the control system of these units. We will discuss the concept of inertia emulation later in the course. In summary, We discussed that frequency is a good indicator of the active power balance in a system. If demand is lower than generation, there will be a frequency increase. On the other hand, if demand is higher than generation, there will be a frequency decrease. When a mismatch in electrical power is present in the system, the connected generators will have to increase or decrease their speed. This will produce an accelerating power on the turbine shaft in order to match the output electrical power and the input mechanical power. The higher the inertia of the generator, the higher the accelerating power. This effect, given by inertia, determines the speed at which the system can recover from frequency drops. In fact, one of the challenges that future power systems will have to face is the lack of inertia due to the higher number of generators connected via power electronics interfaces.